So here we are once again on our road
here
trip.
We are.
We're in the first day of the New England Lacrosse Amherst College Legends.
And
we're here in Longmeadow, Massachusetts with Sandy Dibble. So Sandy, what got you interested in lacrosse in the first place?
Well, that's an interesting question. I grew up at Tabor Academy down in Marion, Massachusetts, where my father taught, and lacrosse was prevalent there, and I just fiddled around with it when I was a kid, and would just be out in the yard, and it was just one of the games we played every day after, you know, after school. We didn't play lacrosse every day, but you'd get out there and just kids go out and play.
So playing in prep school, that gave you certainly an advantage in freshman.
Well, it would have if I had played, but I didn't play.
Oh, okay.
So I was really just, you know, these were just activities.
Okay.
I did some other things. I did some crew. I did some sailing. We had a very good sailing team there. But I had a fundamental, sort of challenge, which I think kept me from really wanting to play varsity sports, which was I can't run. From a congenital condition with my leg and surgery and so forth. So, you know, it just didn't really seem to me to be a very good idea. So I would be very active in playing intramural sports. So I had a great time. I hung around playing sports, and which doesn't really explain how I started playing in Amherst. But. Larry Jones, said to me, you know, hey, you ought to go out for the team and play. So we need a goalie. We need players. We don't have that many players, and we need some guys to play. So I said, what the heck? You know, give it a try. So I did, and, you know, I had a good time.
That was freshman year you played?
Freshman year, I only played 2 years, 67 and 68. And I do take complete credit for the success
year.
Of both. Both of those years. I mean, those were the championship years, and I think it's primarily due to my contribution. I thought that Darp was he was a character to end all characters. Very interesting guy, obviously talented, successful coach. Probably everyone remembers stories. I remember once, I think Bill Bacon might have been involved in the story, I don't know if it was a timeout or something, maybe in a, I don't know if it was a game or a scrimmage, but a couple of dogs started fighting. If you've heard this story, a couple of dogs started fighting down by the end of the bench. And so one of the players went over to separate the dogs with a stick, and the Darp said, I'm thinking Bill Bacon, but I'm not sure. But says, no, leave those dogs alone. It's their responsibility. They have to decide who's the better dog. I'm thinking that's unusual. You know, probably there's probably some real truth in that. And I should be learning something from this.
Yeah.
He's just a really fascinating guy. Scully was a character. I wasn't sure what to make out of Scully. I liked him. He also was very nice to me. I had no complaints whatsoever. I think he was devoted to his players, devoted to the college, and a good person. you talk about Monk, but I mean, you'd think Monk would give him a stroke or something every time he. And I'm sure if he was thinking about what his alternatives were in the goal, I'm sure I would have given me a stroke too. But Scully was a hardworking guy. He wound up and enthusiastic and seemed I think he was anxious to do a good job, and he had some darn good teams. I mean, I think that at some level, that's a measure of, you know, success. I don't think it could have been that easy to put together really good teams at Hammers College. Well, he didn't wear a chest protector, and I didn't wear a chest protector because Monk didn't wear a chest protector. Now, it was both easier and harder for me because I couldn't get hit too much over on the bench. On the other hand, in scrimmage or if you were there, he was going to stop the ball with catch it. I was probably going to hit me if it came through. But I exactly for that reason, I figured, well, that's Monk's not going to do it. I'm not going to wear one either. I might as well just help me focus, I guess. But I did wear a cup.
I was going to ask.
And Monk did too. I'm sure he did. I'm pretty sure I remember him telling me that. You thought about it. You saw some of these guys that really fired the ball. Dave Zarin in my class had a shot like a rocket. And Hilton Foster had a hard shot. But those guys from midfield would really fire the ball. And so, to help you focus, not have a chest protector. I guess one way to do it would be get out of the way. But that wasn't really the plan. We had a trip down to Baltimore for preseason, and then we went up, and I don't know, we played in Pennsylvania and maybe New Jersey or something like that on the way back up. Well, what I remember about, first of all, Baltimore is we got to stay at the YMCA. I don't know who stayed at the Y besides me, but I thought that was not that nice. I mean, it was not luxury accommodations, and I think there were some other guys staying there who were happy to have the Amherst College lacrosse team staying at the Y, too. I didn't know too much about Baltimore, so I think we got some suggestions from some of the Baltimore guys, and a bunch of us went to the Gaiety Theater, which was about as nice as the YMCA, as I recall, but it was an interesting experience.
You'd find time in your busy schedule November 12th to be able to make it back.
I'll be there. I'll plan to be there.
Southern Cross.